For part three, we'll be talking about summation notation. Summation notation is a mathematical notation that we'll be using repeatedly throughout the course. I'm going to introduce this in a very formal way, a way you'd see in other math classes, but keep in mind that we're going to simplify it at the end. So if you find this a little overwhelming, don't worry too much. Just focus on the last like few seconds or last few minutes of this presentation if you just aren't comfortable and you're not planning on taking more math classes after this. All right, so here's summation notation. Summation notation is this capital sigma letter. It looks kind of like a backwards E of sort, or a zigzag. And all summation means is add up the numbers. So for example, if we want to add up the numbers 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, instead of saying add up the numbers 1 through 5, we can write it as add up the numbers, and that's what the summation is, starting at 1, adding at 5, and all we're going to do is just add up the numbers as they are, not do anything to them. And that's why we just wrote an I here. So we start at 1, and then we go to 2, we go to 3, we go to 4, we go to 5, and add them all up, and that becomes 15. And that's the summation notation. Sorry about that. So the I at the bottom indicates where we're starting. I equals 1 means we're starting at 1. The 5 at the top means we're going to be ending at the number 5. So just for another example, let's say we had this. We have sigma, or summation, I equals 3 to 6. So we're starting at 3 and ending at 6. This time, though, instead of having I after the sigma or after the summation symbol, we have I squared. So in this case, we want to add up the squares instead of adding up just the I's. All right, so let's plug in I equaling 3 first, but we're going to square it. So it's going to be 3 squared. Our next number would be 4 squared, then 5 squared, then 6 squared, and then we'll stop because we're supposed to stop when I is 6. Adding up all those numbers, we get 9 plus 16 plus 25 plus 36 for a total of 86. Okay, so moving on. Suppose we want to add up numbers in a data set. So, like, for example, we have our data set x equals 10, 12, 7, 3, 9. So x is the name of our variable. That's often what we will name our variable as x, sometimes y, sometimes z, but usually x. And we're saying the first x value is 10, the next one's 12, etc. Well, to indicate that we're talking about the first x value, we can call that x value x1, or x subscript 1. Then the second x value would be 12, or x subscript 2. X subscript 3 would be 7, etc. So if I want to add up all the numbers in my sample, I would write summation I equals 1 to 5 of X subscript I. So that means my first value would be X subscript 1, and then I would add to it X subscript 2, then X subscript 3, all the way up to X subscript 5. Plugging in those numbers, I get 10 plus 12 plus 7 plus 3 plus 9, for a total of 41. So again, this summation I equals 1 to 5 of xi is just a shortcut way of writing, let's add up all these numbers, 10 plus 12 plus 7 plus 3 plus 9. It doesn't actually help you in the calculation at all, it's just a shortcut way of writing what you want to do. This is something we're going to use a lot in statistics. And because we're going to use it so much, instead of writing summation of I equals 1 to n, where n is our sample size of xi, we can just write summation symbol, or sigma, x. So if you see sigma x, it's just a shortcut or kind of an informal way of writing the summation of I equals 1 to n of xi. So it's just kind of a short, cleaner way of writing it. And we'll be using this throughout the remainder of the course. So you're not going to see the formal way of writing it ever again in this class. But again, if you're planning on taking more math classes, realize that the second way of writing it, even though that's the way we're going to do it in this class, is not really considered formal, and you're not going to be allowed to do that in future math classes. All right, so let's just use this for an example. So consider the sample 5, 9, 6. So we have a sample size of 3, or n equals 3. So let's find the summation of the x's, the summation of the squared x's, and then the summation of the x's, all of that squared. Notice how I'm focusing on order of operations here. The idea is that for the second example, we're saying add up all the squared x's. I'm saying squared x's because order of operations say we have to do exponents first. So we're going to square the numbers first and then add them all up because addition comes last. In this example, though, we have parentheses, so it's telling us to add up all the x's first and then square the final result. All right, so let's work with all three of these calculations. So for our first one, the summation of x, we just want to add up the numbers 5, 9, and 6, and that will give us 20. For our next one, we just want to square each of the numbers and then add it up, so we'd get 25 plus 81 plus 36 for a total of 142. For our last one, we just want to add up all the numbers, which we already know is 20, and then square it, so that should give us 400.